Hello students, welcome to the Science Online class. Today, I am going to explain the chapter Nervous System of class 5. In this video, I am going to cover the human nervous system, the parts of the nervous system that includes the brain, spinal cord, nerves, what are reflex actions, sense organs and the nervous system. Let's start with the nervous system. Students, human nervous system is made up of small structural units called the neurons. These neurons are millions in numbers that are found over our body. Neurons, they are transferring the messages from the brain, spinal cord to the different body parts and from the different body parts to the brain. The whole nervous system is divided into three parts, that is the brain, spinal cord, nerves or the neurons. The brain. The human brain is very delicate organ and is present inside the bony structure called the skull. The human brain is having three parts. The first part is the cerebrum, second cerebellum, and the third part is the brainstem or the medulla oblongata. Cerebrum, it is the largest part of the brain and it performs the functions like the intelligence, thinking, learning, memory. It also controls the different sense organs working. So just because of this reason, the cerebrum is performing. There are so many functions of our body. It is the largest part of the brain. Cerebellum, this part is located just below the cerebrum and is bulb-like structure. It is the shape of this cerebellum is like a bulb. The cerebellum is responsible for maintaining the balancing of the body and it also maintains the different body postures. Brainstem or the medulla oblongata. So it is a stem-like structure that joins brain to the spinal cord. This brainstem, it controls the involuntary actions. Now what are involuntary actions? Involuntary actions are those actions which are not under the control of the brain. For example, like the breathing, heartbeats and the movements of the lungs. The next part of the nervous system, spinal cord. Spinal cord is a tube-like structure. It is passing from the brainstem to the lower part of the backbone. This spinal cord, it is found inside the vertebral column or the backbone. And it passes the messages from the brain to the all parts of the body. Students, the flexibility of the spines, it is protected by the bundle of nerves. Nerves or the neurons, so they are usually of three types, that is the sensory neuron, motor neurons and the interneurons. Sensory neurons, it carries the signals from the sense organs to the brain spinal cord. While the motor neurons, it carries the signals or the messages from the brain's spinal cord to the sense organs. Now, what are the interneurons? Interneurons are the neurons which transfers the messages between the sensory and the motor neurons. Now the reflex action. What are reflex action? So reflex action is an immediate action or automatic action that is performed against the stimulus. For example, like whenever you are touching the hot pan with your hand, you just straight away remove your hand. So how it does? It is just because of the reflex action. So there are other examples like the closing of eyes. When someone is focusing the light suddenly on your eyes becomes closed. So that is also an example of the reflex action. Students, in reflex action, here the brain is not involved in performing the responses. Now, which organ is responsible? That is the spinal cord. This brain, it just only provides the memory space for the storage. Now, sense organs. Now, how many sense organs are there? There are 5 sense organs. That is, ear for hearing, nose for smelling, eyes for seeing, tongue for taste, and skin or the hands for the touch. Now, we will study the each sense organs and the nervous system. The first sense organs, that is the eyes. These eyes are present inside the sockets of the skull. The eye is protected by the eyelids, which help in preventing the eyes from the dust and the foreign particles. So just because of these eyelids only, the dust cannot enter inside the eyes. Eyes is composed of 3 layers. Here you are seeing in the figure. The outermost layer is the transparent layer, which is called as the cornea. Below the cornea, there is a colored ring-like structure called as the iris. And inside the center of this iris, there is a black spot found, which is called as the pupil. This pupil is controlling the amount of light entering into it. So this pupil gets bigger in the dim light while smaller in the bright light. Children, you must have seen this. So whenever you are going in the bright light, you are seeing the things in the bright light, then your pupil gets smaller. While in dim light, your pupil gets bigger to see the things clearly. The innermost layer, that is called as the retina, which is acting as a screen where the images form. Now, inside the eye, there are a bundle of nerves called the optic nerves found, which is sending the messages to the brain. The next sense organ is the ear. This ear is responsible for the hearing. So it has the 3 parts, that is the outer ear, middle ear, and the inner ear. The outer ear or the pinna, it acts like a funnel which collects the sound waves and sends them to the eardrum. The middle ear, it consists of 3 small bones called the hammer, anvil, and stirrup. Together, these 3 bones are helping in sending the messages to the inner ear. Inside the inner ear, there is a cochlea which contains the fluid space, which converts the sound waves into the electrical signals. And then here, there are certain nerves present called the auditory nerves, which sends the messages to the brain. This inner ear helps to maintain the balance of the body. The next sense organ is the skin. Skin is the outermost covering of the body, which have various nerve ends called as the nerve ends, which detects sensations like the touch, heat, pain, or the pressure. It has tiny pores which are helping in throwing out the waste from the body in the form of sweat. The skin is not only covering the body, but it also helps in maintaining the body temperature. The next organ, sense organ, is the tongue. This tongue is responsible for the taste and speech. Inside the tongue, there are so many receptors found that are called as the taste buds, and each taste bud is responsible for the different taste like the salty, sweet, bitter, and sour. Students, you are seeing the diagram of the tongue here. The tip of the front end of the tongue is responsible for the sweet. Side of the front tongue is responsible for the salty flavor. The back end of the tongue is responsible for the bitter. And the side of the back part of the tongue is responsible for the sour taste. So inside these taste buds, there are the nerve cells which carries the messages, taste messages from the taste buds to the brain. The last part of the sense organ, that is the nose, which is responsible for the smelling. The inside the nose, there are special nerves present which help in detecting the different smells, and then the messages are sent to the brain by these nerve cells. Inside the nose, there are hair-like structures formed which filters the air entering inside it. Students, so what we learned so far? The nervous system. The parts of the nervous system, that includes the brain, spinal cord, and the types of nerves. What are reflex actions? And the different sense organs with the nervous system. So let's check your knowledge. Name the largest part of the brain. Answer is cerebrum. Name the part of the eye where the image is formed. It is retina. Name the outermost part of the human ear. Answer is pinna. Which part of the nervous system controls the reflex action? It is spinal cord. Name the part of the brain that plays an important role in balancing of the body. The answer is cerebellum. The next part of this, check your knowledge. You have to answer these questions in true or false form. Reflex actions are not automatic actions. So this statement is false. Neuron is a basic structural unit of the nervous system. It is true. The brain has three parts, cerebrum, cerebellum, and the brainstem. Again, this statement is true. Motor nerves carries the signals from the sense organs to the brain. The statement is false. So which nerves carries the signals from the sense organs to the brain? It is the sensory nerves. The last question, we should clean our body by taking the regular bath. So this statement is also again true. So I hope you have understood the chapter. Thank you all for watching this video.